first of all, Zach, you know, what you got out of him tonight?
Well, what we got out of him was huge. I mean, when you know, you anticipate that we're going to play a doubleheader tomorrow, you hope your Friday guy could go deep in the game, and we had to get two guys up that didn't come in the game. It's still a little wear and tear on them, but we didn't have to use anyone else, which bodes well for us tomorrow. You know, they had to use three guys tonight, and we had to use one. So, you know, tip of the hat to Zach. He wasn't, you know, and I'm sometimes tough on my pitchers. You know, you can look at the scoreboard, 4-0. He gave it five hits, I think. But he walked too many guys. He walked five guys, and that was he overcame himself. Got some big double play balls after he got himself in a jam, and I'm very proud of him because I know he's worked extremely hard to have a complete game, and he finally got one tonight.
The last time complete game, I think they said, was 2006. Last complete game shutout.
Oh, wow, that's a long time, and even more congratulations to him. And I would be wrong if I didn't compliment the defense.
Yeah.
As much as Zach pitched well, if it wasn't for the outfield defense and the defense overall, it would have been hard to throw that shutout. I thought we made some spectacular plays in the outfield, and I'm very proud of our guys for doing that.
Did you ever get close to pulling Zach?
Oh, yeah. You know, I going into the ninth, I had a plan, and then the plan kind of got askewed a little bit when that guy kept fouling off pitches. And then finally he hit a ball that went right up the middle, and A.J. made the play and turned no play because Zach was really close to coming out right then, and I know I didn't want to do that. I'm sure that's not what the fans would have liked to see, but we have a long season ahead of us, and he has a career out in front of him, and I wasn't going to, at the cost of him, yeah, continue to run up, keep him out there.
Three in the first, that's got to be huge. And you all have a knack for scoring in the first. Is there any rhyme or reason to that?
No, I thought we took some good at-bats. You know, any time a guy, our leadoff hitter gets on, especially when it's Will Maddox, we seem to score. And we got some clutch base hits. Pierce Biley got a clutch base hit in that inning. And Pierce had a great game. And it continues to show his experience as a junior college transfer, like Price has done and like Taylor Smart has done. I was happy. I think it settled our team down a little bit. I'll be honest with you. We've talked a lot this week as a team. We've worked on things. We talked about holding them accountable. And I think we were kind of tiptoeing around a little bit. The coaches noticed that during BP. It was almost like they were afraid to make mistakes, and I think the three kind of allowed them to take that deep breath and exhale and just think, okay, now let's put it in Zach's hands and get a Friday win for the first time this year.
Zach, you know, I asked Zach if he pitches any different with a 3-0 lead, and he said not really. Do you call the game any differently with a 3-0 lead?
No, I don't. I mean, obviously you feel a little bit more luxury to give in at times and just, you know, as we call it, 9-on-1 baseball, where let them put it in play and let your defense work. But, I don't think I call a game differently, depending on the score.
Is the 4-0 win better without an extra base hit when your guys are going first to third on singles and stuff like that?
I think we create our extra base hits of how we run the bases. Yeah. And I'm, you know, no matter how we find ways to win games, I'm not going to – I don't – it. Yeah, you know, would I like guys to hit doubles off the wall and hit home runs? Yeah. I think that's coming.
Yeah.
I think that, you know, it's difficult this time of year to hit balls like that. The ball doesn't travel that well. I thought they got into some balls, and Ethan Bennett got into that ball pretty well that went to center field. This time of year, when it's cold like this, the ball's not going to go very far. So we'll do whatever we can to be successful.
Zach kind of reflected what you said, too many pitches, too many walks, didn't have his fastball. Do you like that mindset after a complete game shutout? He's still looking at what he didn't do.
Yeah, because once you feel you've reached the top of the mountain in this sport, you're going to get knocked down. And hopefully Zach knows that he's got to get back to work Monday and Wednesday when he gets back on the mountain in his throwing sessions to keep getting better.
Thanks,
thank you.